Relaxation time again, but even with that, I like to have a closer look at certain things. For example, in the world of chocolate, you wouldn't believe the things which are sometimes going on. Yeah, sure, you would believe that there is a new chocolate bar with a new special flavor. There's always something, and it's pretty much always the same thing, really. But there is a bit of stranger attempts at innovation sometimes as well. For example, Barrica Le Beau quite recently, just a few months back, presented ruby red cacao beans. And recently, Nestle Kit Kat became the first to use them. So there was this Nestle Kit Kat made with ruby cocoa beans. Discover a new chocolate experience. And it made me look at the sort of innovation we find in there. Well, actually something similar had happened before when Valrhona made their dulce chocolate, which they call a blonde chocolate. So you have the usual dark chocolate, the chocolate. You have white chocolate, the one made with chocolate butter, basically. Yeah. And you have milk chocolate, of course, made with milk powder. The blonde one was already an attempt at saying we have something new. It is 32% cocoa butter, so it's basically a white chocolate, but they call it blonde because it is caramelized. Well, here on the back, for example, they have defined it, they have to define it somehow, as is known, as white chocolate. It is a... well, sort of white chocolate, but a bit different, with notes of caramel, because it is caramelized in some way. The ruby cocoa beans are even worse of a story, really, because they are sold as if this is a particular, special, new kind of cocoa bean, like the chuao, the porcelana, those kinds of defined cocoa varieties. Or at least like a Trinitario or Forastero or Criollo, the different basic groups of cacao beans there are. But actually, ruby cocoa beans seem to be, there's of course a whole trade secret behind it, but they seem to be just the cacao beans, not fermented the way they would normally be, but the polyphenols of the cacao treated without the fermentation in a different way, which results in this ruby red color. And that's it. But the taste, of course, becomes different since the fermentation is what gives the cacao its real cacao notes. And so we have something else again. But actually, we have lots of different cacao bean varieties. And those, strangely, only sometimes become or became a trend, like Chuao a few years back, like a few less years back the Porcelana. And now, again, this is somehow not being really considered a whole lot. Some people still look to it, but many people don't. And actually, like I want to say it with the spices, with the chili especially, there's a world of flavors waiting for us to explore it, and we just need to go into a high-class store for chocolates for that, and we can discover them, and discover new aromas, and with them probably things that are a joy, and a pleasure, and better for us, and often enough also made fair trade or similar ways, and so not only good for us, but also for the world, at least a bit better for the world than if you just consume cheap sugar. So maybe think about that a bit and then really enjoy. So you have an invitation to discover, to explore this whole world of aromas, but I'll admit I also want to try this now and see how that tastes. Probably it's mainly just going to be sweet. Well, the color definitely is one for Instagram. smells kind of buttery, rather like white chocolate, and I just had to check if that really wasn't coming from my hands from what I've been baking. It does taste quite fruity in a way which is interesting coming just from the cacao beans or from the preparation of them, but it is at the same time quite a fruity Kit Kat.